Hey there! In this video, we're going to take a look at different ways you can interact with your Supabase database from your Flutter app using the REST API endpoints. Let's dive in! Before we get started, I want to give you one tip, and that is to always use snake case when naming anything within Postgres. If you use uppercase for your table name, you'll end up having to wrap them in double quotes whenever you reference them in your SQL code. Having uppercase doesn't really have any advantages, so just keep things simple and always use lower snake case. Let's first talk about inserts. You pass a map to the insert method to insert a data. If you pass a single map, you insert a single row. If you pass a list of maps, you can insert multiple rows in bulk. When inserting data, leave out those columns that have default values set, like created at, if you just wanted to have the default value inserted. Also, speaking of default values, did you know that you can use the auth.uid function as the default value whenever you want to reference it in the database? This way, user ID is automatically inserted in your database without you having to explicitly provide it from your Flutter app. Now on to select. You can use the select method to get data from your database. By default, it'll return all columns of your table. You can narrow down which columns you want to retrieve by passing them onto the select function. You can also retrieve data from foreign tables. Let's think of an example where we have profiles table and posts table. Each profile has many posts associated with them. We call the relationship between profiles and posts one to many because one profile is associated with many posts. We can retrieve a list of profiles and the associated posts in a single query like this. When we do this, Supabase knows that each profile is associated with many posts, so it'll return posts as lists. Let's flip this and say we wanted to retrieve all the posts and the associated profiles. Since Supabase knows the relationship between these two tables, it'll now return each profile as a single map. Now let's look at another type of relationship, many-to-many. Let's introduce a tags table. You could imagine a blogging app where each post can be associated with multiple tags and each tag can be associated with multiple posts. This relationship is called many-to-many. We need a post table, tags table, and a join table in the middle. This join table holds two foreign keys, one for posts and one for tags. In this relationship as well, Supabase is aware of the relationship between the tags and the posts, and you can return values by querying them like this. Notice that the join table doesn't show up in the query at all. In a many-to-many relationship, either way you query it, the foreign table will always be a list because there are many of them associated with each main table object. Now let's talk about filters. Filters in Supabase are a way to narrow down your query result. For example, EQ filter is used to narrow down results where a specified column has the specified value. NAQ is the opposite and will return rows where the specified column is not equal to the value. These filters can be chained to each other to form a more complex query. You can also filter the foreign table results by prepending the column with the foreign table name, followed by a dot. Other commonly used filters include GT for greater than, GTE for greater than or equal to, LT for less than, and LTE for less than or equal to. But there are many other filters, so be sure to check out our documentation. If you filtered your data and still are getting too many rows, you can use the limit or range modifier to limit the number of results you receive. Limit simply limits the number of return rows to the specified number. Range can specify the starting index and the ending index of the return rows. In this example, I am retrieving the 3rd to 6th data. Limit and range are almost always used with the order modifier to reorder the resulting datasets. If you know that a query will return one row, you can add single modifier to change the return type from a list to a single map. Note that single will throw in an exception if you have more than one results returned. It'll also throw when you have zero results returned. When you know that you have one or zero results returned, you can use the maybe single modifier to change the return type to a nullable map. Finally, let's talk about count option. Count option can be used to get the number of rows so that you can properly paginate your data. Using count option will change the return type to Postgres response, where you can access the data from the data property and count from the count property. If you want to count the number of rows of a foreign table, you can use the common keyword to do so. In this example, I am retrieving the list of tags as well as how many posts each tag has. And that wraps today's video on database querying with Flutter and Supabase. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, and join our Discord. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time with more Flutter and Supabase contents.